Hi guys, welcome to Duc Fam Photography. My name is Duc Fam and you can find me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and my website at ducfamphoto.com. So today I'm going to show you how to install all of the plugins that you have in Photoshop into Affinity Photo. First thing is we have to check in the Photoshop. This is my Photoshop CC 2017. You go to Filter. And you can see that I have, let's say we have Nick Collection from Google here. In Nick Collection, I have like about 7 or 8 plugins over here. Okay. And then open Affinity Photo. And open the setting. On the setting panel, you can see the Photoshop plugin right here. Click it. By default, you have nothing in here yet. So go ahead, click Add in the plugin search folder. And then navigate to application, Photoshop CC, and plugins. And Google. Inside Google, you can see like all of the plugins that we have from Google. Okay, so go ahead, select Google, and click OK. So we'll see the part right here: the applications, Adobe Photoshop CC 2017 plugins, and Google right here. Okay, and then click Close. In this tab. Affinity Photo will ask you to restart the application. Go ahead to do that. Alright, after Affinity Photo restarted, you can see the list on the left, all of the plugins that Affinity Photo detected from the Google folder. But here we have a couple of plugins says require global support. Okay, so go ahead to click Authorize Global right here. And doesn't matter where you are in the dialog, just go ahead, click Authorize. And now it turned from Require into Working. And then for all of the others, plugins that say Unknown right here, make sure you check the box Allow unknown plugins to be used, and then click close and restart the application. Alright, and now you on set. Go ahead, close the setting and open a picture and test it. Alright, right here you can see check in filter and the plugin, and you have Nick Collection right here, exactly like you have in Photoshop. Okay, go ahead, test one of them. Let's say color effect. All right, right here we have too many options of the color effect that give you, okay. Do some tweak right here, like that. Right, and more contrast. All right. And then click OK. All right. So right here we have before and after using Nick Collection. Alright, that's all for today. If you like my video, just give it a thumb up and then subscribe my channel. A lot of videos like this are coming soon. Thank you for watching. Have a good day. Bye.